aim of the study was to examine in detail the injecting practices of drug injectors, with a specific focus on the factors which may lead to transmission of hepatitis C. We also identified, though, instances of indirect sharing, and these could took place in two ways. First of all, by mixing up needles, and that could occur where you had injectors who either lived with another injector or who injected habitually with another injector. Now, in one instance, for example, we had two females who were living together and didn't actually want other people to know they were injectors, so they actually stored or hid their needles and syringes in a nest of coffee tables. And we actually saw them retrieving those needles and syringes on one occasion, and when the needles came out, it was quite easy to see that there was no way of knowing which needle and syringe belonged to which female in that house.
Is that yours or mine? No, it's mine.
Now, one of the reasons that mix-ups occur so frequently is because the vast majority of people in our study used the fixed 1 mL diabetic needle and syringe for their injections, and therefore were unable to tell one from the other. I think 88 out of the 103 injections we saw were with a fixed 1 mL needle and syringe. And out of those 88, only 11 were marked in some way to distinguish them for further use. Some people burned with a lighter the end of the plunger so that it was blackened and they would know it was theirs the next time. Other people scraped one of the numbers off the barrel, so that they could distinguish that needle and syringe was theirs. This was also able to let them know the number of times they had used that needle. So if there was three numbers that had been scored off it, they knew they had used that needle three times previously. One of the things that we found in this study was this potential to mix up needles and syringes. And the reason for that was that the vast majority of injectors were using the same kind of needle and syringe, in this particular instance, the 1 mL fixed needle and syringe. I think what we have to find is some way that the injectors can actually distinguish between these needles. And that might be by producing the syringes with a different colour on the top rather than just the orange. It could be that we could produce the needles and syringes in a different kind of format. Maybe the barrel could be rough or a different shape or whatever, so that people who are living together could each pick a different type of needle and syringe to be used just for themselves.